When working with any sort of compounding, whether it's inflation rates, interest rates, etc., it's very important to understand the difference between a nominal and effective rate. So just to explain firstly what it means, if I'm told that I'm going to get 12% effective compounded monthly, if I create my little bucket, you'll see I start with 100 Rand. If I assume that that means 1%, what it means is in month one, we had 100 Rand, we get 1%, so that's 1 Rand. Now it's 101. In the second month, we've now got 101, which means that the interest we earn is 1 Rand and 1 cents. So at the end of this period, you discover that instead of earning the 12% effective that we thought, it's actually 112.68. This is because in the calculation, we shouldn't use the effective rate, we should use the nominal rate. So we could play with this to work out what rate gets us to exactly 112. So we can do that, I suppose. Another way we could do it, if you know about GOALSEEK, I could go to the GOALSEEK and I say I want that cell there to equal to 112 by changing this cell here. And you'll see it works it out. Or better yet, it's to use what Excel has got built in to switch between effective and nominal rates. So what we're going to do then is over here, we want to calculate what the number is. Now we have calculated it, but let's use, I'm going to say I want to work out what the nominal rate is. In Excel, you've got two functions. One's called nominal. When I say OK, all I have to do is point at the effective rate. So in this case, I know it's 12%. So there's the effective rate there. And tell it how many periods in this compounding. I'm going to say 12. Gives me a number. Let's just convert it to a percentage. And I know that that's the nominal rate. So what I should do is take the nominal rate, divide by 12. And you'll see that now compounded monthly ends up with the correct number. The other function for this is the effective rate. So if someone tells you the nominal rate, like that one here, there's a function in Excel called effect for effective. And what it does is that I can point at a nominal rate, tell it the number of periods, and it will then calculate with compounding what does it effectively mean. So effectively this nominal rate will give you that much effectively at the end of the period. Let's see why that's important. If I've got this example here, what I have is I have got a whole bunch of costs and I'm told that inflation is an effective rate of 6%. Now inflation could be measured in two ways. So either you have costs that stay the same and then at the end of the year they jump up, or you can have costs that just steadily climb up monthly. Either way, however, if we're saying inflation is effectively 6%, an amount that starts at 1, both methods must end up at 1.06. So let's see if we take this, I'm just going to go and divide this by 12, and I'm going to say take the price and multiply it by 1 plus our monthly charge. Let's see if we get the same number. And you'll see what it does is because we've used the incorrect starting point, when we use this method, the cost is 1.0617. Here it's 1.06, and these should be the same. The reason this is not working out is because this is an effective rate, but we're now calculating it monthly. So we need to convert it into a monthly rate or a nominal rate. So that's when I can use my nominal function. I'm going to say that's the effective rate. How many periods? 12. Gives me a percentage. Remember, I need to divide this by 12 because of the way I'm using it here. what you'll see now is it doesn't matter whether we use a step-up approach, where costs stay the same for a full year and then jump, or we go monthly, we end up on exactly the same number. And this is very important, especially when you go out further, because keep in mind, if you're not careful and you're going out 60, 120 months, this gap can be quite wide.